Hey everybody, how are you? Well, I'm back again for another video. Lanista requested this one because she was like, you gotta put this one on there. You haven't done this one. Well, I'm gonna do the sea moss, as you can tell from the description down below. And first off, this has 92 minerals. Like, there's a total of, I believe it was 102 minerals total for the human body, but it contains 92 by itself. If you know about the Dr. Sebi, however you might pronounce it, he talks a lot about it and teaches a lot about it being really good as a detox for the body. So give me 1 minute. I'm going to show you what it looks like. We're going to start with cleaning it and then we'll get to it. I will actually show you guys which brand I am using. Got this from Etsy.com. You might be able to see it. All right, and I'm cleaning it now. Let you guys take a little look at it. Check it out. Look how it looks. Stringy, right? The more you do it, the more you'll be able to get used to it, but check it out. All you're really going to do is just kind of let the water go through it. I usually like to use cool water. You just got to make sure you get all the sauce off. Because you don't want all that, you know, like, all on the sea moss. Just like, you know what I mean? You really got to make sure you clean it thoroughly because it's very important. Check it out. Look how fluffy it is. I mean, this company, I would definitely say yes to. I've got some from different companies, and like, I don't know, it's like, they wouldn't impress me. But this company, I like it. Every once in a while, you see like little pieces that might not be so good, and just get them out if they look too dark. That's usually what I do. But this one is mostly just clean and clear. Oh my gosh, it's so pretty. Look at it. Oh my goodness. It's so fluffy, y'all. I am definitely satisfied by this company's sea moss. Takes a little longer to get in the mail depending on where you are. Can't remember exactly where it said it came from. But I absolutely love this sea moss. Look at it. I'm getting it all on the sides, so I gotta get that. Can't be wasting no sea moss, y'all. Can't do that. But it's not expensive either. It's like, I think I spent about probably like almost 30 on this one, which is not bad. Because, I mean, look at all this. And it fluffs up even more. Like, as you're cooking it, all you're really going to have to do, you're going to see me do this as soon as I get started with it. But I take the sea moss after I'm done cleaning it, get a pot, soak it for about a few hours. Some people like to soak it overnight. It's really up to you and what you want to do. But this time, I really want to get it made, so I'm probably just going to soak it for about I'd say about an hour or two. But I'm not going to do the whole batch today. Or will I? I guess we'll see. Half the time, like, I might do half of it. Okay, alright. I'll do half of it just for y'all. But I'm going to keep the other half bagged up, because sometimes I like to do different things with it. At least you'll be able to see how I make the gel. So right, I'm going to show you guys the type of water that I'm going to use today. I love this water. I absolutely love this water. I mean, you have to hug this water when you get this water. I mean, it's so good. It's like $2 or $3 a bottle, but I'm telling you, it's way worth it, like, on everything. Get this water. I use this for my face, so I think it's very beneficial. Also, I've done this experiment where I've got two different plants and put them in. One of them was like in the sink water, faucet water, whatever you want to call it. And the other one was with this water. And the plant that had this one lasted like two or three weeks longer than the regular faucet water. I'm weird. I do crazy experiments. Like, I try stuff out. It's just who I am. And that's how you find out. That's how you learn. So, I mean, I would definitely recommend this water. Like, get this water. Spend the money. It's worth it. All right, well, I'm going to get the sea moss. I'm going to have it soaking in this for, like, probably about 2 hours, like I said. And I'll be back to let you know when we're going to start the process for the gel. All right. See you in a minute. So I ended up letting it stay a whole night. So I thought it would be best, because more than likely when you do it this way, it cooks a little bit faster and it'll have more of a liquidation versus just so much solid pieces. But it's up to you. Alright, y'all. So, I ended up letting it stay overnight, but it's the best thing if you want it more like liquefied. Well, I'm about to get to cooking it. I got it on like a 5 or 6. Yeah, it's on a 5. So, I have it on 5. I'm going to let it cook for, I'd say, an hour and a half. But it's up to you and how fine you want it. If you want it more like a gel base, like I like to have mine, then cook it as long as you think. Like, just go based on when you stir it, when you mix it, like what you get. So I can't really tell you a time on what you should or should not do. So just kind of go based on what you like, you know, the texture to be. So I'll be back. We've decided to let you in on our fun. I'm going to clean everything in here. Got some crab, got some mussels. I'm going to clean all this. Clean everything. And I'll be back. It's ready for the grill, y'all. Let's do it. Let's get it. Hey. 30 to 40 minutes. 1 cup. This black cup here. Let's go. Boil these for about 30 minutes. And then I'm going to take them out add them in a pan with oil and give them a nice little crunch before I add them. I'm just extra like that. They taste better, so you'll be happy. The last 5 minutes, I always like to put it on broil. Gives it a little texture. All right. Looking good. Sea moss not ready yet. Just me and my baby. And you know Lanise got her own.
Thanks for watching.
I mean, once you do this, time to refrigerate, and that's it.
You ain't no her, right?
Let's
go.
No masterpiece. 10 bad bitches and they after me. One bad bitch look like a masterpiece. Looking for a dump like an athlete. Big drip, what you call it? Big drip. You got the bad, but can't afford it. Even if I ride it like a jet ski. Some of the bad bitches, they harassing me. They like because I rap and be with the athletes. Stop asking me, I know they mad at me. Hop in the coupe, then I slide like it's Vaseline. West Coast 6, bulging like a trampoline. Take a break out, put it on the triple beam. I'm not from Canada, but I see a lot of teams. Dismantle up, I know how to handle up. Light the candle up, make you put a banner up. Toss a 50 up, make them tie the club up. Took your bitch out the game, I had to sub up. No masterpiece. 10 bad bitches and they after me. One bad.